Okay, so this is the final sampler that I made. It's really long. I didn't measure beforehand, so it's kind of too long to be a scarf. But I'm going to use it as a winter banner type of thing in my house. And so I'm going to go through each technique, show you what it looks like, and then talk to you about my experience weaving that technique and things I learned during the process. Because this whole thing I'm doing is just self-education. So at the end of this technique, I have chained. And you can see the chains that I wove into the fabric. One of the chains that I spun so that it can be a fringe. So that one just kind of hangs free. And I really like how one of the chains is just woven into where you can almost see through it. That was really cool. This was fairly easy to weave. I decided that the weight of the chains was catching on my warp. So I ended up cutting this yarn into smaller sections so that I could weave it more easily. But that's the only issue I had weaving that one. And that wove really easily compared to all of the embellished techniques. This one was super, super easy to weave. And I really like how it came out. This is feathered. Feathered was really fun to weave. And I like that I could put feathers on both sides of the weaving. So I could control like what side I wanted the feathers to be on, and so that was cool. This technique, the popped technique, is in the tan. So these are the pops from the technique, and I have some out of cotton, alpaca, locks, sparkle, hemp. And so those were fun to weave. Since I'm not really good at that technique because I think I've been using the wrong fiber, maybe something like merino would work better for that. But as a weaving, it's really forgiving because if you end up creating a texture that you're not totally into, you can just, or if it doesn't feel secure, the weaving secures it into your fabric. So that's awesome. And then this section right here is knotted. Just this part. Because I didn't have as much length with all of them. And it's hard to see, like, this is a knot right here. It's hard to see maybe the difference between that and popped. But I liked it. Again, some of my knots I thought were not very secure, but then when I wove them, they got super secure. This section right here, actually, I did a lot of that one, and I really like how that came out. Especially when I did like the bobbles, you can see one is right here, one's right here, and one's right here. Section right here is textured, where we did a bunch of different techniques in one. I have one twist kind of hanging out of there, and that was amazing. Like, you don't know what's going to happen next when you weave that. Love this part right here. It's really pretty. Okay, next is puffed. These are two puffs that I spun, that I spun and then foot in, and then on the back. One thing I like about weaving is that both sides of the fabric are usable, so you can kind of take your textures and balance them on both sides, and that's really neat. That was pretty easy to weave. You can see it on both sides of the fabric. This section right here is knotted. And some of you may remember when I spun a rolag into the yarn, and this is the rolag right here. So I just ended up weaving that as part of the texture. And this is a knot right here, kind of a heart-shaped knot that I thought was really cute. This is also a knot right here. The next woven section is, I really love how this one came out. And I think the reason I love it so much is that I spun it from a Nessaland art bat, and there's a ton of little crimpy feathery texture in there that is just divine. Next is Locked. The long locks hanging out. This one was a little bit more challenging to weave because I had so many locks back to back that I had to kind of pick them out of my warp threads. And I had a lot of yardage for this, but it all ended up looking kind of short. And I think my preferred way to use yarns like this is as warp. That way the locks go all the way through the scarf instead of just being like this. But it's still really pretty. That would make a gorgeous pillow or wall hanging. This technique I was really excited about. This is thickened. And I'm glad that you can see through it because to me it almost created triangles. And when I held it this way, it looked very landscapey to me, like mountain ranges. And so I thought, how pretty would it be to spin something dark to light and hang that as a wall hanging and have it look like a mountain range that fades into the distance. I just thought this one was probably the one I was most surprised about and that I liked the most. And that's why I wove so much of it, because I couldn't stop. So I really, really, really liked that one. I also loved how when all the thin spots went together, you would get kind of holes in your fabric. I thought that was cool. Here's beaded. Spinning beads into yarn. There's another bead on the other side. Here is braided. The braids ended up making thick sections of fabric, which were really fun and wavy to work with. So here's a braid right here. I also in the beaded did like a bead at the end of a twist, so that's from beaded. This thick section is a braid. This thick section is a braid. So all the thick sections were braids in the yarn, and they created really beautiful kind of incorporated thick and thin textures in that part of the weaving. This is angled. That was probably one of the easiest ones to weave. It wove up really fast, and I loved how all the textures just popped out so easily. That yarn was meant to be woven. And then this is twisted. And those just kind of hang out of the yarn. And then on the other side, there's more too. So that this would be a great yarn for fringe, pillow. You could weave this. I probably should have woven this at the beginning, so it ended up being like fringe for this if I wanted to wear it as a scarf. But it was a pretty simple to weave. You could also incorporate the twists. If there's too many, you could also just kind of like lock them into your weaving, which would be great. This is blocked. And when we were spinning block, we were spinning a self-striping yarn, and you can see it totally stripes from bat to fabric, bat to fabric, bat to fabric, bat. So that came out lovely. This is coiled. And coiled has so much twist in it that the weave actually is stretchy. And I thought it would be cool to use coiled as the center of your warp and put a ton of tension on it and make a scarf. That way, when you take the scarf off of the loom, all of that tension and that stretch kind of goes back together, and you'll end up with like a really ruffly scarf. And so I'm going to experiment with that later. But coiled was the hardest one to weave as weft, because all the little bumps kept like catching on all my warp threads. So it was like, it was challenging. So that was not my favorite one to weave, but I think it would be lovely as warp. Yeah, all of this is also coiled. And then we have laced, which was very fun. All of our lace embellishments are locked in super tight. And I love how they just, I don't know, like I love them. I think they're super fun. And we have a couple of the ones that hang down. In this technique, we experimented with a whole bunch of different ways to sculpt lace. So each one of these is a cute little embellishment. And so I thought that was fun. And this is unlocked. And in unlocked, there was I did a section with a couple Suri locks. So you can see those in there hanging out. And here's the back of unlocked. Ooh, the lace is in the way. Here, let me do it this way. That one was easy to weave. The last one that I have in my sampler is lashed. And this one is by far the softest one. It almost feels like a teddy bear. It has that fuzzy, fuzzy, fuzzy texture. So it's super, super soft. I guess the only warning I have about that is that if you were to weave something that you were going to wear a lot out of this texture, it's possible it could become kind of matted down, kind of like a fuzzy blanket or something. When you put it through the wash, it just ends up looking worn. So if you do weave something out of this, just be very, very gentle with it. I love how you can see the fuzz on both sides. And that is all of it. It's just, there's so much of it. 20 single techniques in one giant scarf. What a project. I have learned so much through this whole series, and I am appreciating all of the feedback I'm getting from you. I hope this was helpful for you to see maybe what these yarns could be used for and what they look like woven. I do think that art yarns really sing in weaving because a little yardage goes a long way. All of the texture is allowed to be seen, and the fabric is, it creates a thinner fabric. So yeah, I totally recommend picking up a little rigid head of loom and experimenting with some of the fibers in your sash. There's a lot you can do with weaving. Thank you for watching, and happy spinning.